One thing about the holiday season, it allows all of us to step back and just reflect on how good the Lord has been to us and to also enjoy ourselves with loved ones. And so this holiday season, I'd like for you to do two things. I'd like you to think about all the men and women in uniform who are protecting the precious freedoms that we have and that we enjoy who are not home. But also at the same time, when you have your loved ones around them, show them how much you love them. And thirdly, for many individuals who may not have anything, when you think about the blessings that you have, think about maybe some of the individuals who don't, some of the individuals who are homeless, some of the individuals that you see on the street, that you think about them and share a little bit of the blessings that the good Lord has given you. I wish everyone a very happy and safe Christmas and New Year's. God bless you.
Hi, I'm Glenn Davis, and I'd like to wish you and your family and all of yours a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year's for me and my family.
I'm Bruce Huff, your city representative of District 3. I thank you so much for the opportunity to serve you every day, and I wish that you and your family have a happy holidays and a gracious New Year.
Hello, I'm Evelyn Turner Pugh, Councilor District 4, Mayor Pro Tem. From my family to yours, may you have a blessed and safe holiday.
Mike Baker, City Council District 5, wishing you and your family Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and a great, wonderful New Year.
Hello, I'm Gary Allen, Council District 6. From our family to yours, we'd like to wish you a special holiday season, Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year.
Happy Holidays to each and every one of you, and a Happy New Year. Feliz Navidad y próspero año en el nuevo año. Que Dios los bendiga. May God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Walker Garrett. I'm the city councilor for District 8. I want to wish everybody in the city of Columbus, my constituents, those who are visiting our town, happy holidays and Merry Christmas. I hope you have a wonderful time with your family and that you stay safe and enjoy the time off. But as always, feel free to call me because I never take time off.
I want to wish you and your family a Merry Christmas, a Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, Feliz Navidad, and may 2017 be the best year ever.
I'm Skip Henderson, citywide representative on District 10 for the Columbus City Council. During this holiday season, my family and I want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a very happy, safe, and prosperous 2015.
Hello, Columbus, Georgia. I'm Mayor Teresa Tomlinson, and it's my great privilege to serve this city as mayor. I want to thank you in this holiday season for all you do to make this city bright and vibrant and thriving. It's all of our families and all of our employees that make this a wonderful city. And so at this special time of the year, I want to tell you how grateful I am for you, and I hope you have a very Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Hello. I'm Isaiah Hughley, City Manager of Columbus, Georgia. On behalf of the City Manager's Office, from our family to yours, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We wish you a Merry Christmas
and a Happy New Year.
From all of us in Inspections and Codes, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
From your Columbus Planning Department, we want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
The members of the Columbus Department of Fire and Emergency Medical Services would like to wish everyone Happy Holidays, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year. Happy Holidays!
From our engineering family to yours, we want to wish you
a Merry Christmas
and a Happy New Year.
Everybody got a little light under the sun, under the sun.
From all of us at the Columbus Civic Center and Columbus Ice Rink to all of you, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Ho, ho, ho.
Hi, on behalf of the Department of Public Works and the Special Enforcement Division, we'd like to wish you and your family a very
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Hola, de parte del Departamento de Control de Animales, te deseamos un buen
Feliz Navidad.
On behalf of the Finance Department, we'd like to wish you
a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
As we are ending this Thanksgiving season and moving forward into the Christmas season, and we are just so grateful and thankful for the many blessings that we have received individually as well as collectively. And now we just want to say to you, the community, and our viewing audience, from the Clerk of Council's office, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey!
From my family here at Metro Transit System to yours,
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
As we begin to enjoy the holiday season and step back from the hustle and bustle of daily activities, the Human Resources Department would like to extend these holiday wishes.
May the peace and joy of the holiday season be with you throughout the coming year.
My name is Lula Lunsford Huff, Muskogee County Tax Commissioner, and I'm standing here with my awesome staff. We are so very grateful that you gave us the opportunity to serve you during 2016. We wish to you and your loved ones a very, very
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
From our family to yours, happy holidays.
Merry Christmas.
Christmas.
We changed up so many times.
We won't never have it right again.
She's fixing your hat right here.
I don't want Kevin in this.
Don't breathe in my hair.
All right. Five.
Wait. Let's practice.
We got to practice.
Before you start shooting.
Damn right. Newbies.
It's a one time deal.
All right, we're going to say from your Columbus Planning Department, we want to wish you
Feliz Navidad.
Merry Christmas
and a Happy New Year.
Oh, okay.
That's what you're going to say now. Okay.
And so then you start parks to end it.
Please don't.
Kill us all.
That tree may
kill us. We did have a live tree here.
We did have a live tree here.
All right.
So you starting off?
Yep.
Okay.
All right. And five, four, three, two, and one.
From your Columbus Planning Department, we want to wish you a happy Christmas.
Who said a happy
birthday?
What the hell's wrong with you?
Merry Christmas and a happy
birthday.
That's how
I said happy.
Christmas first, then happy
birthday. Yes,
Christmas.
The house is on fire.
Yeah, that's what we need to say.
Okay, let's try that one more time.
Okay.
One more time.
Can you see Chief of Trail? Right. He's hiding behind me.
You
he's
hiding behind me. Put him on the couch. Chief of Trail.
Hey, she acts like she's 6 feet. Chief?
Right. He's doing like this. Aren't you doing like that?
Yeah.
Y'all ready?
Okay. And let's see. You got the end come out just a hair.
Oh, then you'll see me.
That's what I'm trying to do here. Okay. And. Okay. Four, three, two, one, go.
The house. No, Chima.
No.
That was the last instructions I got. All right, here we go.
From all of us at the Columbus Civic Center and the Columbus Ice Rink, we want to wish you Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
That was terrible, guys.
Maybe at the end you should say, ho, ho, ho.
Okay.
Okay.
And one.
Hello, I'm Isaiah Hughley, City Manager of Columbus, Georgia. On behalf of the City Manager's Office, the staff of this office wish you and your family a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Let me do it. Yeah. I guess I should say we wish you and then you.
Right. A Merry Christmas. Right. You is
we
the word.
Wish you.
Okay, we wish you, and then I'll pause. Mm-hmm. Hello.
Stop.
Yeah.
Four, three, two, one, go.
Hi, on behalf of the Department of Public Works and the Special Enforcement Division, we'd like to wish you all a very happy
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
I jacked that one up, didn't I? I'm sorry. That was a margarita.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
On the first day of Christmas, my city gave to me one public works employee.
On the second day of Christmas, my city gave to me two
one public works employee.
On the third day of Christmas, my city gave to me three recycle bins,
two pair of gloves,
one public works employee.
On the fourth day of Christmas, my city gave to me four potholes,
three recycle bins,
two pair of gloves,
one public works employee.
On the fifth day of Christmas, my city gave to me
four potholes,
three recycling bins,
two pair of gloves,
one public works employee.
On the sixth day of Christmas, my city gave to me six trees of sway,
five garbage trucks,
four potholes,
three recycle bins,
two pair of gloves,
one public works employee.
On the seventh day of Christmas,
Christmas my city gave to me. Seven sweepers sweeping.
Six trees are swaying.
Five garbage trucks.
Four potholes.
Two pair of gloves.
One public works employee.
On the eighth day of Christmas, my city gave to me. Paper mechanics reaching.
Seven sweepers sweeping.
Six trees are swaying.
Five garbage trucks.
Four potholes.
Three recycling bins.
Two pair of gloves.
Eight mechanics wrenching.
Seven sweepers sweeping.
Six trees are swaying.
Five garbage trucks.
Four potholes.
Three recycle bins.
One public work employee.
On the 10th day of Christmas, my city gave to me. 10 dogs are running.
9 ladies typing.
8 mechanics wrenching.
7 sweepers sweeping.
6 trees are swaying.
5 garbage trucks.
4 potholes.
3 recycling bins.
2 pair of gloves.
1 public works employee.
On the 11th day of Christmas, my city gave to me. 11 plumbers plumbing.
10 dogs are running.
9 ladies typing.
8 mechanics wrenching.
7 sweepers sweeping.
6 trees are swaying.
5 garbage trucks.
4 potholes.
3 recycle bins.
2 pair of gloves.
1 public works employee.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my city gave to me.
12 drains are draining.
11 plumbers plumbing.
10 dogs are running.
9 ladies typing.
8 mechanics wrenching.
7 sweepers sweeping.
6 trees are swaying.
5 garbage trucks.
4 potholes.
3 recycling bins.
2 pair of gloves.
1 public work employee.
This is Rochelle Sawyer reporting to you live outside the courtroom of Judge Ebenezer Scrooge. We're here for the Christmas Eve emergency bond hearing of Rudolph Reindeer, aka the Red Nose. Rudolph is in jail on charges of burglary, criminal trespass, and criminal damage to property in connection with his annual visits to the Columbus area. The district attorney, Gertrude Grinch, is expected to oppose bond because she feels Rudolph is a flight risk and a danger to our community because he comes here only to commit crimes. Santa and all his reindeer and his elves are here to support Rudolph in this last-ditch effort to free him before the Christmas Eve deliveries. Judge Scrooge is not known to be a compassionate judge, but the fate of Christmas and the happiness of billions of little boys and girls hangs in the balance. We take you live inside the courtroom for the bond hearing.
Set of order in the court. I am calling the case now of the state of Georgia versus Rudolph Reindeer. This is a bond hearing to see if Mr. Reindeer can be released this evening for Christmas Eve. Is the state ready?
Yes, Your Honor. Gertrude Wrench on behalf of the state.
Well, Ms. Grinch.
It's Wrench, Your Honor. Wrench.
Gertrude Wrench. Grinch.
It's Wrench. R-I-N-C-H, Gertrude Wrench, Your Honor.
Wrench.
Wrench.
All right, Ms. Wrench, do you oppose this bond?
We do, Your Honor, and I'd like to be heard on the various factors as to why this defendant should not be released.
Well, do you have a reason you think maybe he's a flight risk?
Indeed, Your Honor. Flight comes naturally to this defendant. In fact, he's rather talented at it. It's an important part tool to the crimes that he commits. Your Honor, he's here on very serious charges. He's looking at felonious criminal damage, charges involving the destruction of rooftops throughout this fair city. Your Honor, one of the other factors we look at in a bond hearing is ties to the community. And this defendant has no ties to the community. Indeed, the only contact he has with his community is the destruction of rooftops throughout this fair city. Nearly everyone. Well, not everyone, but nearly everyone, Your Honor. I mean, He poses a significant risk to committing more crimes if he is released.
No.
I've been in contact with the National Criminal Information Center, Your Honor.
And,
well, while it's true he doesn't have a juvenile record, apparently, he never played any reindeer games. We have Alabama, Alaska, Arkansas, California. It goes on and on and on and on and on. Wyoming. And, Your Honor, I'm awaiting more statistics from Interpol. Apparently, this reindeer gets around. Your Honor, I'd hope to have some witnesses for this emergency bond hearing. However, I had an investigator put together a call bank, and we've called 32,000 different individuals, and I can't seem to get a witness to come for this hearing, and...
Not one single witness.
No, Your Honor, but you see, one of the additional factors the court must consider in a bond hearing is whether or not there is a significant risk of the intimidation of witnesses.
Intimidating, you say?
And, Your Honor, I have reason to believe that should this defendant be released, that he will engage in bribery.
No. Bribery?
Bribery of potential witnesses.
How so?
Well, in the form of gifts. Gifts to boys and girls. Your Honor, look at this defendant. You know, all the reindeer love him. Mm-hmm. In fact, they know him by his street name, the Red Nose.
Did they used to laugh and call him names?
I don't believe so, Your Honor. It's a very shiny nose, Your Honor. I'm going to ask this court to take judicial notice. You can even see it glows.
Yes, you can.
Your Honor, this red-nosed reprobate is a one reindeer wrecking ball to the rooftops of this community.
Mm-hmm.
We would ask that he be held without bond, at least for 90 days, until I can get such witnesses to come forward in this case.
Well, Miss Grinch?
It's Wrench, Your Honor, Wrench.
I'm sorry, Miss Wrench. You have made a very compelling argument for the state of Georgia against bond. I commend you. Now, Mr. Frost, Mr. Jack Frost.
Yes, Your Honor.
What say you?
Jack Frost for the defense. I say that this is outrageous, preposterous, ludicrous, and a bunch of other words that end in U.S. And the U.S. is founded on freedom. She is trying to deny my client's freedom, so she must be against the U.S. And I, for one, won't stand for it. I call Santa Claus as my first witness.
Very well.
Yes, Your Honor. Will you raise your right hand? Do you swear or affirm the testimony you're about to give shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
And can you state your name for the record?
Well, I go by many different names, but I suppose Santa Claus would be appropriate for this proceeding.
Then may I call you Santa Claus?
You may indeed.
And how do you know my client, Rudolph?
Oh, Rudolph here, he is my most valuable reindeer. He leads my sleigh on Christmas Eve every year so I can deliver all the gifts to the wonderful and good children throughout the world.
And would it be fair to say that you need Rudolph with his nose so bright to guide your sleigh at night?
Absolutely. He is indispensable every Christmas Eve, and I absolutely need him.
What would happen one foggy Christmas night if you did not have Rudolph with his nose so bright?
Your Honor, hazard to think what would happen without Rudolph to lead my sleigh on Christmas Eve night. I don't know that Christmas could go forward. I don't know how I could get all the gifts to the wonderful children throughout the world. And might I say, all the wonderful jurists that are throughout the world as well, Your Honor.
Objection, Your Honor! He's attempting to bribe this court.
Oh, sit down, overruled. Don't forget Santa Claus my cigars.
Oh, I won't, Santa. And by the way, Miss Wrench or Grinch, whatever you go by, you have richly earned your lump of coal again this Christmas.
Cross.
Now, Santa, if His Honor and His infinite mercy were to release my client on bond, he'd be released into your custody, is that right?
That is correct.
And you live at the North Pole?
I do indeed.
And this is a very isolated region of the world where Rudolph would be no threat to our community.
It is a very isolated area.
And were you to leave the North Pole with Rudolph, he would be in harness under your care, is that right?
He would be under my supervision and care, that is correct.
Thank you, Santa. I have no further questions for this witness, Your Honor.
Thank you. Do you have any cross-examination, Ms. Grinch? Wrench?
Your Honor, it's obvious. This witness is biased for the defendant. I mean, it's obviously obvious.
Is it obviously obvious?
Indubitably obviously obvious.
I see. Well, I agree. All right. Any redirect?
No.
You have any other witnesses, Mr. Frost?
Yes, Your Honor. I have many other witnesses. I have Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen, as well as a few of Santa's helpers.
A couple of elves. My God. Mr. Frost, I have been hearing songs about these reindeer since Halloween on the radio, and I think I know about anything possibly they could say, and I know that they are happy with Mr. Rudolph reindeer. So if you don't mind, let's just dispense with any testimony from them.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Do you have any further witnesses?
No, Your Honor. Only argument.
Argument. I have a question for Mr. Claus. Mr. Claus, you see the Rudolph sitting there with you.
Oh, indeed I do.
He looks rather stupid, don't you think? Do you think he's under the influence of drugs and alcohol as we speak in this hearing?
Oh, Your Honor, perish the thought. Rudolph is the smartest reindeer I have. He is a virtual GPS to guide my sleigh, and he has guided it perfectly for many years so I can deliver all the gifts to all the wonderful children throughout the world. And also, as to this drug usage, Your Honor, there's no such thing, or alcohol abuse or any sort. Rudolph, to my knowledge, has never had any alcohol or drugs, as have none of my reindeer. We have a drug-free workplace at the North Pole. So, Your Honor, just perish the thought entirely.
I see. Well, that answers my question. Thank you, sir. All right. Argument, Mr. Frost?
Yes, Your Honor. I suspect this is personal on the part of Prosecutor Grinch. She tried something like this 2 years before with Santa himself. I suspect it because she is on the naughty list.
That is most definitely true. She has been on the naughty list for many, many...
Objection, Your Honor, objection. What is the relevance to what list I may or may not have been on for nearly all of my life have to do with this hearing?
Naughty list? You have a naughty list, Mr. Claus?
It's a very secretive list.
Well,
it changes from year to year.
I need to know if Miss Grinch is on it.
Indeed, Your Honor.
Thank you, sir. Proceed there, Mr. Frost.
She has a personal agenda against Christmas. Think of the children snug in their beds with visions of reindeer running through their heads, waiting on Santa with his sled to bring joy and happiness. The only crime here is the DA is trying to steal Christmas. I request an OR bond. That would be an own reindeer bond for my client. Thank you, Your Honor.
Own reindeer?
Yes, Your Honor.
I see. Very well. Well, the state has presented a very cold, bleak, dark view of Christmas, and that's one way of looking at it. And Mr. Reindeer, through his attorney, Mr. Frost, has presented a warm, light, happy view of Christmas. And I like that. So what if a few shingles get knocked off a roof in Columbus, Georgia? So what if we get a little reindeer poop on the grass? There may be a few complaints to the city manager, but I'm sure the city can take care of that. I think Rudolph deserves to bond out of jail. However, Judge Scrooge declines to grant bail. Instead, I'm going to dismiss all his charges and ask Mayor Tomlinson to give him the keys to the city so that all children will have their Christmas tonight.
Well, you've heard it here, folks. Christmas is back on. Jack Frost and the Public Defender's Office have saved Rudolph. Tuck those kitties in, because Santa and all his reindeer are coming tonight. From all of us at the Public Defender's Office to all of you, have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Thank you. So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you.